When we at the Watershed think about building or rebuilding infrastructure for 21st century communities, we try to look at the big picture and reflect on past practices. It is also our opportunity to look at new technologies, new partnerships, and new solutions. We try to look at how we can make all of the many systems needed to support urban living work more effectively together. In the past, when we've looked at infrastructure needs, for example, stormwater, roads, sanitary sewers, drinking water, energy parks, and so on, we've tended to plan for and build the system separately. What we're trying to do now is identify how these systems are interconnected and supportive of one another in order that we can design them in ways that make them work together to be more cost-effective, sustainable, and resilient, and in some cases, restorative. Towerside is an example of how this change in focus to integrated systems planning led to building a district stormwater system that is a more cost-effective solution for stormwater management while also providing additional benefits to the district community.
The Towerside District Stormwater System is a stormwater reuse system. It's designed to capture, treat, and reuse stormwater runoff from a group of private properties in the Prospect Park neighborhood in Minneapolis. All the rainwater and melting snow that runs off of these properties will flow into a pair of treatment areas called biofiltration basins, which are connected by an underground pipe. Instead of going into the storm sewer system like it normally would, the runoff from these properties will be directed into these basins. The basins are filled with engineered soils and native plants that treat the dirty runoff by removing pollutants from it, kind of like a giant rain garden. So things like bacteria, sediment, and excess nutrients are all captured in the biofiltration basins. Underneath the larger of the two basins, there's a 200,000-gallon storage tank. After the stormwater runoff has soaked into the basin and been filtered through the soils, it drains through an underground pipe and flows into the tank. From there, the water can be pumped out to the neighboring properties and used for things like irrigating plants, maybe flushing toilets, or for even industrial uses. So in addition to removing pollution, we're also creating a new sustainable water resource. In our watershed, all of our stormwater runoff drains directly to the Mississippi River. So by managing our stormwater in this way, we're actually keeping pollution out of the river, which not only helps us, but helps people downstream.
The more we can get out and look at how can we take infrastructure that traditionally has been designed independently, so you might have a utility line, a stormwater line, a sanitary sewer line, some streets, and everything's on its own grid emplacement. We've now said, how can we bring all these systems together and integrate them together and put them in, install them, have them play off one another? What are the synergistic effects we get? And as a result, we're saving money, we're increasing benefits to the neighborhoods and the developers save money, we attract economic development. So that's the realm we're trying to work within, is create new innovative management techniques for stormwater in these urban settings.
This area, because of its size, because of its blank nature, this could really become a living laboratory demonstration of what's possible. How do you rethink, retool, built inner cities to be a demonstration, a replicable model, really, of what sustainable urban redevelopment really looks like?
I think the thing that's really exciting about this project was the fact that we were able to work with four developers and the city to develop a project where the district system was actually built and completed, and that we have mechanisms in place to show how that can be managed over time to be cost effective. What this begins to do is to look at how that water that falls on that land either stays on the land, or if it leaves it, it leaves it in a manner that's similar to what it did before we had development there in the first place.